The bracelet is worthless, mademoiselle. It is copper only. I bought it outside the train station in Istanbul for my arthritis. Take it if you like.
I'm very sorry, Your Highness. I realize how this must look, but I am only doing the job assigned me. I promise I'll return it to you, if I can.
Ah, then I expect you would like to interrogate me. I believe that is the correct term.
If I may.
But of course. I am suspect, just as anyone in the Calais coach must be. I am ready for the third degree.
I have borrowed your passport, Your Highness.
I noticed that as well.
Natalia Dragomirov, 17 Avenue Kleber, Paris. You are traveling home from Istanbul, madame?
Yes. I have been staying at the Austrian embassy. My maid is with me, as you saw in the marketplace.
Could you give me a brief account of your movements last evening?
Nothing could be simpler. After dinner, Schmidt, my maid, read to me. We were interrupted by the train stopping to avoid the avalanche. Then she read aloud to me some more until quite late.
Can you give me an idea of the time?
If I were to guess, I would say it was 1:30.
Has your maid been with you long?
15 years.
Do you consider her trustworthy?
Absolutely. Her people come from an estate of my late husband's in Germany.
Forgive the personal nature of this question, madame, but what is the color of your dressing gown?
My dressing gown? It is of blue satin.
You have been in America, I presume, madame?
Many times.
Were you acquainted with a family by the name of Armstrong?
You speak of friends of mine, mademoiselle. Sonia Armstrong was my goddaughter. I was on terms of friendship with her mother, Linda Arden, one of the greatest tragic actresses in the world. As Lady Macbeth, as Nora in A Doll's House, there was no one to touch her. I was not only an admirer of her art, I was a personal friend.
Is Linda Arden dead?
No, she is alive. It is a sort of life. She lives in complete retirement. Her health is very delicate. She must lie on a sofa most of the time.
Mrs. Armstrong had a sister, did she not?
Yes, much younger than Mrs. Armstrong.
And she is alive?
Certainly.
Where is she?
I must ask the reason of these questions. What have they to do with the murder on this train?
The dead man was responsible for the kidnapping and death of Mrs. Armstrong's child.
Ah. In my view, then, this murder is an entirely admirable occurrence. You will pardon my slightly biased point of view.
It is most natural, madame. Where is the younger daughter of Linda Arden, the sister of Mrs. Armstrong?
I have lost touch with the younger generation. I believe she married an Englishman some years ago, but at the moment I cannot recollect the name. Mademoiselle, you will forgive me, but the one you assist, he who guides the investigation, no one has told me his name.
He is Hercule Poirot, madame.
Poirot. Of course. I thought his face was somehow familiar to me. Poirot on this train. It is destiny.
I have returned to you, Your Highness.
I thought you might.
I'm having some difficulty locating the owner of this handkerchief.
I am sorry to hear that. If you had asked me, I could have told you it is mine.
Why did you not tell me that Elena Andreigny was Madame Armstrong's sister?
Her mother was my friend. Of course I would protect her if I could.
Yours? But, Your Highness, your first name is Natalia.
I'm perfectly aware of my first name, mademoiselle. My handkerchiefs are always embroidered with Russian characters. In the Cyrillic alphabet, H is written as N.
How did your handkerchief come to be lying by the murdered man's body?
I have no idea.
Your maid said she did not recognize this handkerchief.
Schmidt believes in loyalty as I do. I believe in loyalty to one's friends and one's family and one's class. If I remember the name of the Englishman Linda's other daughter married, I will inform you at once. I think Monsieur Poirot is very lucky indeed to have you assisting him, mademoiselle. Cassetti? That monster? On this very train? And Poirot as well? Oh, we are but puppets of destiny. Mademoiselle, I suggest you look elsewhere for your murderer. When your investigation is complete, I would like my handkerchief back. And my copper bracelet? Soon this entire affair will be behind us all. If only you and that Belgian detective will allow it.
Au revoir, Princess Dragomirov. Thank you very much, Princess. Thank you for your time, Princess. Good day to you, Your Highness. Good evening, Your Highness.
I will hold myself at your disposal in a while, Mademoiselle. This talk of murder has tired me so. Perhaps we can talk later. You may have more of my time later. I promise.
I regret to tell you that I must take your fingerprints.
Dear me. With typewriting ribbon? Have you something I may clean my hands with afterwards?
I'll have to find something to use. I'll take your fingerprints later.
Thank you for your consideration, Mademoiselle.
I have some paper napkins.
Thank you, Mademoiselle. Those should suit admirably.
I'd like those fingerprints now. I have something to clean your hands with.
Thank you, Mademoiselle. Those should suit admirably.